Very good morning to all. My name is Dr. Ravi Kumar. I'm working as a librarian and government degree college Ramanapet, Yadadri Bhuvanagiri district. Today we are discussing about the open education resources. Right now we are in the information communication technology era. So in this information communication technology era, everywhere you go, they are asking about the quality resources, quality of education. Where we can expect from the quality of education, we will provide the quality of the resources, we will provide the quality of the education, then only we will expect from the quality of the education, quality of the teaching and quality of the resources. When we will provide, then only we are expect from the people and the students, from the colleges, from the quality of the education. So where actually these particular resources we can expect, like we can purchase this much of the journals or books. It is not possible to pay that much of amount for the government degree colleges or government institutions and education institutions. How, where we can get the resources? There are plenty of the resources freely available, open education resources. How we can get these particular resources, where it is available from the Indian side, where it is available, which institutions taking initiation, or foreign institution, which institution taking initiation for the open education resources, that we can access the open education resources. Only we have to show the path where these particular education resources are available. Now we are going to discuss about the open education resources. See, open education resources are learning material that is freely available for use, remixing and redistribute. See, I mentioned here, just you see, information public resources for all. Actually, as for the father of library and information science, S.R. Ranganathan, the first law he shows that information for use, books are for use. That means whatever the information he is producing from the publisher or like website, whatever it may be, information that is resources to all. That means to utilize the particular resources. That is the intention I mentioned in that information public resources to all. The second one is digitized material, offered freely and openly for the educators and self-learners and researchers for reuse for the teaching and learning and the research purpose. That means this particular digital material or whatever the digital material are available, that particular resources for the using for the education purpose, learning purpose and research purpose. The open educational resource movement is a part of the global effort to make the knowledge available to all. That means, you know, we are discussing right now, we are in the this information for all. That means globalization of the education, or democratization of the education, means education is for all. Like that, these particular resources, information is for all, democratization of the information. Information anyone can access. There is no restriction, there is no boundaries. Anyone can access from this open educational resources. Where these particular open education resources are origin, in the 2002 UNESCO, the forum of impact of open courseware for the higher education in developing countries. This is funded by the William and Flora Hart Foundation in the 2002, started from the UNESCO. The what is the definition for the open education resources? The open education resources are teaching, learning and research resources that are researched in the public domain. That means put in the public domain, have been released under the intellectual property license that permits their free use of the repurposing by others. That means whatever the learning resources that put into the public domain, that means anyone can access from this public domain. And what is the open education resources? It includes the full courses material. It contain textbooks, it contain video lectures, it contain audio lectures, simultaneous streaming of the videos, tests, software, and used for the support, access to the knowledge to anyone, globally anyone can access. Actually, these particular open education resource movement started in the 2001. Halt and Andrew W. Mellon Foundation, jointly funded by the MIT Massachusetts Institute of Technology Open Courseware. these first institution is taking initiation. These particular institution is making all the courses material freely available to put into the public domain. Anyone can access, like these MIT Mozart Search Institute of open courseware conducting course material that we can access from the online. Since then, more than 60,000 additional institutions also launched open courseware website. That is initiated by this MIT courseware only. Open education resources. What is the open education resources? It contains what are the open education resources? Learning materials, learning objectives such as quizzes, crosswords, puzzles, and flashcards, animations, and etc. It contains audio lectures, video lectures, images, sounds, and music. And entire course contents, like course modules also, we can in the open education resources. And collection of the journals and collection of the articles and textbooks and etc. It contains the open education resources. See, here this one diagram is there. But I mentioned that globalization of the education, globalization of the resources. That means anyone can access. The first one, you check it out here, remove of barriers. That means open education resources, anyone can access without restriction, without barriers. The second one is, you check it out here, sponsor the high quality of the open content. High quality means whatever the open courseware material or open education resources, it's not a ordinary resources, a high quality standard content materials, content produce, content modules are available, and understand to utilize where these particular resources are available and understand how we can access. This is the thing, understand and stimulate the use, and afterwards equalize the access. That means anyone, equalize, there is no caste and creed, like anyone can access. Equalization means anyone can access the resources. That means open education resources are anyone can access from the where that particular open education resources are available. But only thing, we have to know the source, where the particular resources are available, how we can access. That is the main important. Another one, benefits of the open education resources. What are the benefit? See, we are in the information communication technology era. We are totally far with the traditional education system. That's what, to avoid the teaching from the textbooks, where how we are going to teach the to the students except textbooks, like we are classroom, web classrooms are there, virtual classrooms are there, and we are teaching from the blackboard system has gone now, computer systems, we are providing the teaching by the PPTs, we are providing the teaching from the doorsteps, like from the TVs, like a distance education, you check it out. From the Doordarshan, we can take the classes to the students also. The second one is broaden to use of alternative to the textbooks. Alternative to the textbooks with maintaining the instructional quality. Then another one is lower cost of the course material, very lower and less cost of the course material for the students. The fourth one is 4 R's, reuse, redistribute, revise, and remix. Then another one is democratization of the knowledge. That means these particular knowledge, these particular resources are anyone can access. The last and least one, it's not a least, better, faster, stronger, and collaborative education. That means we are expecting from the quality education from the students and the faculty members. And it is communication technology, whatever the the technology has improved, like that this quality is the faster and stronger education and collaborative in the education system. Then another one is where these particular open courseware sites, MIT Massachusetts Institute of Technology, Open Courseware Consortium, Yale, Open Michigan, John Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health, another one is the Harvard Medical School and Carnegie Mellon, Tufts University, Notre Dame, UC Baker University, Tufts University. The various open courseware sites are there. We can access from the open education resources from these particular. I'll go for MIT open courseware. It shows that this particular MIT open courseware is the fee publication of MIT courseware material that reflects the almost all undergraduate and postgraduate subject taught by the MIT. That means this particular Massachusetts Institute of Technology courseware material is available from the undergraduates and graduates from the this graduate can access the resources and the study material or you know course material access from the this MIT courseware. MIT courseware is a web-based publication of virtually all MIT course content. Course content also we can access. The open courseware is open and available in the world, and it is a you know like a permanent MIT activity. These particular course material are put into the public domain. It's a permanent activity of the open courseware of MIT Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Anyone can access. That's what it is, a permanent activity of the MIT. Another one is MIT courseware, you know, like it was started in 2002 by the 50 courses. By June 2013, MIT Massachusetts Institute of Technology completed 2,150 courses in 30 academic departments, and 2008, from the 2008 onwards, audio visual contents plus subject to modules added into the YouTube and iTunes U. Then another one is 225 mirror sites around the world. 125 million visitors are visiting for this MIT courses. This MIT team, open courseware team, is updating existing sources and whatever the latest course material is adding for the in the MIT courseware. Then another one is course by the department. What are the courses offering from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology open courseware? You know, like social sciences is there, sciences is there, arts is there, defense is there, and agriculture is there. Various type of departments, various type of disciplines are offering various courses. Yes, you check it out. Aeronautics and astronomics and athletics and physical education. You know, biological engineering, engineering and technology also is there. Biology, brain and cognitive sciences, chemical engineering, chemistry, civil environmental, earth sciences, economics, political science. Even you check it out, health science and technology. Health science and technology, foreign languages and literature, arts also conducting. Then another one is Stanford open courseware. These particular Stanford engineering professors are offering three most popular computer science courses for free online. These particular Stanford University professors are offering three most important computer science programs are free online. The Stanford invented to the Future Research University through the teaching and learning innovations by the supporting undergraduates and graduate professionals and lifelong learning. This is the Stanford University website. See, just you check it out, faculty and students instructions and centers, what are the student resources, what are the student resources are available, just we can access. Then another one is Open Michigan. Open Michigan is the collection of open initiative and projects at the University of Michigan. The Open Michigan supports the open access and use of Open Michigan, University of the Michigan resources for the teaching and learning and research. The Open Michigan promotes the open content licensing to support reuse, redistribute and remixing of educational material for use by the others worldwide. That means see, this particular Open Michigan University is supporting the open educational resources, that open access, like use of open resources. Open resources for to whom, to what purpose? To the teaching purpose and learning purpose and research purpose. To whom going to the access these particular resources? Self-learners, researchers, educators, it may be students or faculty members, anyone can access from the put into the this public domain, Open Michigan. See here, Open Michigan website, find is there. What are the resources are there available? Just you find the resources and put into the access into the these particular resources and share the resources. To whom the share the resources? It may be shelf learners, it may be educators or researchers. To anyone can share the resources. Another one is Tufts Open Courseware. This was first published in June 2005. Open Courseware project is a web-based publication of educational material from number of top university courses, provides open sharing. See here, one of the interesting know that, you know, provides open sharing of free searchable high quality of course content to educators, students and self learners throughout the global community. That means this top open university courseware is providing open sharing of free searchable high quality of course content, high quality of course module, high quality of the course material to the educators and students, self learners throughout the global community. And TAFT, open courseware initiative encourages the publication, the free exchange of the material, course material worldwide. That means these, whatever the course material is publication or is providing open courseware material from the TAFT, this is exchange from the another open course initiative who are going to provide the open courseware resources. Then another one, this is the TAFT open courseware website, and you check it out. School of Dental Medicine, School of Medicine, these are the courses, and these are the institution supporting with this TAFT course open courseware. Another one is Open Culture. This Open Culture, 500 free online courses from the top university. This particular Open Culture is the best free cultural education and media on the web. This is the 500 free online courses. This particular Open Culture is offering 500 free open courses from the top university in India. See here, OUR collaboration, Teachers Without Borders. Like that, you know, teachers can teach anywhere, any corner of in the globe, can teach simultaneously. The open access resources, like students or educator or like, you know, researcher, there is no border to access the resources by these particular open educational resources. Any corner, anywhere, we can access the resources without restriction. Just that particular diagram shows that equalization of the resources, the quality of the content or quality of the subject modules, we can access. There is no restriction. That's what they mentioned, that Teachers Without Borders. Like that, the students, the self learners, object researcher can access without borders, without permission, can access these particular open education resources. These particular main open education resources, intention is to connect the educators and learners from around the world. And give the free access of the wide variety of the resources and wide variety of the course material to helping the education, to whom actually self-learners are, educators are the faculty members are, researcher. That means to connect the educators and learners. This is the main intention of the open education resources. To whom actually these particular open education resources are producing? From the foreign side, you could take example of the Massachusetts Institute of Open Courseware, Foothill Dianja Community College and District Sharing of the Free Online, and John Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health Open Courseware, Tufts University. Another one is the EduCommons. Then another one is Carnegie Mellon University, Kanaxian, Monterey Institute of Technology. These are the various institutions are offering like open education resources are producing from these particular institutions or initiatives. See, another one is Wikivarsity. That means this is the Wikimedia Foundation project devoted to the learning resources and learning projects and researcher for use in all levels, all type of education, all styles of education, from primary and even preschools to university levels. This particular Wikimedia Foundation project, in this particular, it is providing from preschools to university level resources. It may be contain learning resources, learning projects and learning researches, research, whatever it may be, that we can access from Wikivarsity. That means the course level is from, that means resources level from the preschool to university level. And also it includes the professional training and informal training also available in the Wikivarsity. Teachers and students and researchers are invited to join create a open educational resources. See, it's a one of the important thing, you know, like you see, check it out. Teachers and students and researchers are invited to join in creating open educational resources. To whom these particular educational resources mean? Teachers and students and researchers who are well versed in this particular area. They are asking to join with them and to create a open educational resources to the global society, to the society, to whom actually, who require this particular open educational resources. See, this is the Wikiversity website, and another one is Wikictionary. Like, you know, this is also Wikimedia Foundation to produce a free and complete dictionary, like in every languages. These particular, 158 languages is providing and simple languages in English, simple language in English. That means online free dictionary is there. This is wiki based open content dictionary. That means 158 languages dictionaries are available. That means it is to simple language, simple English language. That means common people can understand the these particular open educational resources. That's what 158 languages open educational resources, that open dictionary we can access. And another one is Wiki Educator, and Wikipedia also is there. This is the Wiki Educator website. Then another one is difficulties. Really, what type of difficulties we are facing? You know, resources for the faculties. This is another one. And training for the faculty and learners. How really we can access? See, that we have to, just I told you, path is required where these particular resources are available. Simultaneously, how we can access, that is, training is required for the faculty and learners. Technical assistance also is required, software and hardware, and copyright, and then one of the most and important issues, copyright and IPR issues also is there, quality assurance and delivery of the mechanism. These are the some of the hurdles is there for the open education resources. Another initiative is there, open education resources handbook. The handbook is designed to help the educators find, use and develop and share the open education resources to enhance their effective use in online and classroom. This means this particular handbook intention is to help the educator where these particular resources are available. That's what they said, that help the educator to find the resources, to use the, utilize the resources and develop the resources and share the open education resources to enhance the effectiveness. That means optimum utilization of these particular resources in online, simultaneously in classroom also. This is the main intention of the open education resources handbook. This is the open education resources handbook for the educator website. Another one is Khan Academy. This is one of the most important institution, like slogan. The main intention is, slogan is, a free world class education for anyone, anywhere. It's a non-profit organization. The democratization of the education, the democratization of the information, the main content, it shows that a free world class education for anyone, anywhere, from anywhere they can access, they can utilize. Natural, that means online education, it contains over 300 million lessons are available. That particular video tutorials are stored in YouTube. Then another one is, this particular Khan Academy is created by the Salman Khan in September 2006. What are the subject is going to offer? Mathematics, history, health sciences, medicine, you know, like finance, physics, chemistry, biology, organic chemistry. You know, these particular subjects are covering the Khan Academy. And so this particular Khan Academy is supported and run by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. What are the Khan Academy resources? You know, video library with over 4,300 videos are various topic, various disciplines, different. It may be, it contains social sciences, multimedia is there, and another one is arts is there, languages is there, and various specific subjects are there in the 4,300 videos are there. Over 260 million lessons are available. Then another one is, see, last one is another important thing is course for the students and coaches. Simultaneously here, parents and teachers also can track their student progress. How these particular students are, what is his performance? That means parents and teachers can track the performance and record or progress of the students. This is the Khan Academy website. This is the another one is Alison, Advanced Learning Interactive System online. It was launched in 2007. A slogan, yes, you check it out. Earlier, a world class education, that means Khan Academy, world class education from anywhere to anywhere. Just like that here, a new world of free certified learning. That means a new world, free certified of learning. Launched in 2007, Alison has delivered 60 million lessons and records 1.2 million unique visitors are visiting for every month, and 250,000 graduates are there in this particular Alison, and 500 courses as on January 2013. This is the Alison website. Just you check it out. What are the courses, categories of the courses, and by the subject, by the publisher. See, study level, it may be diploma level or certificate level, all courses. This is the website of this subject wise, by subject, banking are there, the various disciplines like arts and social sciences, and sciences, engineering and technology also is there. Another one is Learn Street. Is a company that provides the online education website for the computer programs. The main intention of this Learn Street is the website offer the beginner levels of the courses for the Ruby and Python and JavaScript, to whom these particular courses are starting level, beginner level of the courses, only for the computer sciences programs, just maybe Ruby and Python and JavaScript. This is the coding of the Learn Street website is there. Just you check it out. Free courses are there. This is the teacher tools also available. That means it may PPTs are there, and videos are there, video lectures are there, audio lectures also available on the Learn Street. Another one is Udacity. Udacity is a non-profit educational organization. It is funded by the Sebastian Thurn, and this particular institution launched in 2012. See, this is the Udacity website. See, I did not mention here this particular slide. Actually, this particular Udacity is offering 750 courses and also 1,50,000 students, graduates are enrolled in this particular Udacity initiative. Then another one is 72 subjects are offering open courseware, is conducting open courseware. Then another one is CORE, China Open Resource for the Education. This is also one of the important initiative. This main intention is open sharing of the educational resources. Open sharing of the educational resources between the Chinese educational institutions and international universities, with CORE invention as the future of world-class education. Future of the world-class education. The mission of the particular CORE is to coordinate the use of open courseware from the MIT and other universities within the China, and also enhance the quality of education in the China, and also quality of the education in the China. And another one is offer Chinese open courseware sharing globally. That means anyone can access. These are the core objectives, one of the most things you check it out here. Core objective is to build the wide area of the network for the users, and wide area of the subject content or wide area of the content modules to the students and the faculty members. And 500 to 1,000 universities and educational institutions and industrial partners on this particular core. And another one is 10 to 20 million users are using right now. More than 5,000 courses or modules for the subject item. Then free access via internet, anyone can access. Then another one is Flat World Knowledge. Flat World Knowledge is the popular publisher. Is one of the free important textbooks are available and educational supplements also available from this particular flat world knowledge. This particular initiative, this particular institution is providing free textbooks. College level textbooks are publishing from this institution. It is founded in 2007 by Eric Frank and Jeff Shettle. This particular institution headquarters is located in Washington DC. Just you see another important thing is before November before 2012, the company is originally offered every textbook, whatever the textbook is publishing from this particular institution, that particular textbook is available and put into the free access under open content pragmatism paradigm. That means the whatever the textbook is publishing from this flat world knowledge, that particular textbook can we can access from the like flat world knowledge initiative. This is the website. Another one is connections. This is the one of the important initiative. Connections is the global repository of the educational content. That means it is a global repository of educational content provided by the volunteer. Volunteer means who are volunteers, like they are well expert, well versed in the creating open education resources, the education resources. That means that's what global repository of educational content, educational modules. The platform and maintained with this particular connection is the Rice University. The collection has the collection is available for the free of charge and available for the remixing, editing, and it is available for download in various digital formats. See some like open education resources are available in the text format and PDF format and XML, various formats are available. But this connection, we can access these particular resources on various digital formats. That means any formats we can access. Then this is the institution. Just you see, these are the courses: arts, business, humanities, languages, and popularly. And open library is yours. This is one of the important initiative. Open library is a online project intended to create the one web page for every book ever published. This is the main intention. Whatever the book publishing, they put into the one web page. That means this published book put into the open website, then public domain, that anyone can access. This is created by Aaron Swartz and others. And also this particular open library is funded by the California State Library and the Cale Austin Foundation. It claims have 6 million authors. It claims have 6 million authors in 20 million books they are written. See, these all right now we discussed about the foreign initiatives. Now we are going to discuss about the Indian efforts, Indian initiative. Sarva Shikshana Abhiyan, National Knowledge Commission, National Mission on Education through ICT, that means NMEA ICT, Brihaspati, Vimukti, Sakshat, NPTEL, and Ignana Kosh, Ekalpa, Ekalavya, Vidyanidhi, so NCRT online textbook, NDL, National Digital Library. See, these are the institutions are providing open educational resources. See, National Mission on Education through ICT. That means this is parent body of the MHRD, Minister of Human Resource and Development, centrally sponsored scheme to leverage the potential of the ICT in education. That means to interact, to inject to the information communication technology in the educational level from the preschools to higher education level. The government, the central government is going to interact, inject through the information communication technology by this particular NMEECT platform, e-learning by the EduShot and DTH platforms, online interact with the teachers, and EPG Patashala is one of the option is there. Another one is Sakshat, educational resources to explore the world of web-based knowledge. That means this particular initiative Sakshat is to explore the world-based knowledge resources. That means the particular resources are the world-based knowledge resources. Scholarship, to know about the scholarship opportunities and details, where are the scholarships are available, which institution is going to provide the scholarships, opportunities for the which courses, whatever it may be, that particular details we can know from this sakshat. And another one is testing. Test the upgrade and your knowledge and skills. Test and upgrade whether that particular skills we can improve or not. Then we upgrade whether if it is our knowledge skills is not up to the mark. That means we can learn from this particular sakshat mission. Another was interact. Interact with the teacher and mentor in a real time. See, if you have any doubt, like a sakshat in particular area or particular course, that means we have a T in the like interact is there. This is the sakshat. Just you check it out. Here educational resources, scholarship. You see educational resources, scholarship, testing and interact. Then Vimukti. Vimukti provide online webcasting software, e-learning solutions, webinar training software, live broadcasting, live streaming, whiteboard and online. This is the virtual classroom in the real time. See, this is the website. Another one is NPTEL, National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. It was, the main intention of this NPTEL program is to enhance the quality of education in engineering education in the country, developing curriculum-based video and web courses. This particular NPTEL intention is to enhance the quality of education in the engineering education by the, developing the curriculum. Which type of curriculum based, like a video and web courses? A joint venture. This particular NPTEL is joint venture of IITs and IISc. See here, 7 IITs and IISc Bangalore, 600 faculty members are working on the 600 more than faculty members are working on that. Beneficial actually, these particular NPTEL initiative, open educational resources, who are going to beneficial all engineering and physical science here, undergraduate and postgraduate students. Yes, you check it out. All engineering and physical sciences undergraduates and postgraduate in the country, and simultaneously all teachers and faculties in the sciences and engineering universities in India. That particular resources are to help to access to whom means those particular people they can access. Another one is EPG Patashala. This is very important from the Indian initiative. EPG Patashala, a gateway to all the postgraduate courses. See here, this is the website EPG P and infobnet.ac.in. A project, a project is under National Mission on Education through ICT for the development of e-content for the 74 subject area. 74 subject areas we can access the resources. 4000 plus experts are working on that, and we are expecting quality. That means here you see that high quality interactive curriculum based e-content, high quality of the module, high quality of the content, e-content of the resources are available in the EPG Patashala. Till now uploaded courses and subject is 14,578 modules are uploaded. Then another one is uploaded subject is 17,985 modules. That may be it contain e-text or videos. 300 more are being uploaded. That means e-text and videos and e-text 17,000 plus, 14,000 plus videos and 4,000 plus experts are working on that. 30,000 plus quizzes are quiz material resources are available. 74 subjects are available. 723 papers are available. Just see here, 70 subjects and 4,000 plus experts are working on that. These are the papers are there and these are the subjects, like what are the subjects are going to connect. Just you check it out, subject, e-content here. Then another one, e-jnanakosh, a national digital repository to store the index, preserve, distribute and share the digital learning resources to anyone can access. Actually, these particular resources to whom distance learning institutions in the country. These particular e-jnanakosh is these particular resources. These particular resources are distance learning institutions in the country, and this particular e-jnanakosh is protected and all rights are reserved to the IGNO. And another one is this particular IGNO initiative, anyone can access, but thing is registration is required. That particular registration is free, anyone can access. See here, e-Gnana course, just communities in the Gnana course, just you put into the, just click on the Indira Gandhi National Open University. Just if we click on that, just go through that one, Indira Gandhi National Open University, IGNO, and YouTube videos are there. Here, Indira Gandhi National Open University, IGNO, a recent submission, whatever the, here, School of Humanities subjects, how many resources are available, how we can access, these are the thing in the IGNANA course. Vidyanidhi, another digital library and e-scholarship portal. The Vidyanidhi, the main intention, treasury of the knowledge. These particular Vidyanidhi from the Indian side, you know, Indian premier digital library initiative to facilitate and the creation, archiving and accessing of the doctoral thesis. Accessing of the doctoral thesis from the this Vidyanidhi. See, this is the website. And another one is NCRT. This particular National Council of Educational Research Institution, mainly in the graduate students and postgraduate students who are appearing for the competitive examinations. See, we are expecting where that particular resources are available, how we can accessing of the competitive resources. See, this particular NCRT is providing the first standard to 12th standard English and Hindi textbooks are available in the NCRT website that we can access freely. There is no restriction. And also see here, flip book of classes 1st to 12th standard. E-publication is there, textbook of the classes 1st to 12th standard, PDF format is there, another one e-publication is there. Ekalavya, another open source knowledge initiative 2011. This particular Ekalavya initiative is all India level is there. This is maintained and created by the run by the partner by the IIT Bombay, ASL and Kanwal Reiki School of Information Technology Education. This particular web portal is set up for the Ekalavya, aims to exchange of the knowledge and ideas by placing all the relevant material. This particular relevant material to whom require these particular relevant resources put into the open source, thus making considerable to contributant to the society, contribution to the society. Which society? Open learning society. That means these particular people, like what I said, you know, like self-learners, learners and open education students, like the research scholar can access the resources. See, these are the, another one is this initiative is target group who this particular resource are beneficial means technical education students such as BE, MCA and MSc, CSIT and electronics. These projects, see here, manifested by e-guru, e-outreach, e-content. These particular areas like e-guru, we interact with the teachers. Outreach, where actually these particular resources are that we can go. E-content and e-module, how many e-contents and modules are available. These websites are support 5 formats, DVDs, VCDs, text slides, Ekalavya. Another important, Shodh Ganga, this is a very, very important. See, the now the College of Commissioned Education is going to celebrate in the every year, you know, like research skills providing, that means to inject the research skills to the students. That's what they are providing in the part and parcel of the various research activities. Like Shodh Ganga provides a platform of the research scholar to deposit their PhD thesis and make it available to open entire scholar community. Anyone can access these particular resources. These particular resources, those who are submitted to the Shodh Ganga, that all full text of the thesis and dissertation that scholar community can access, and simultaneously to capture these particular resources, capture and index and store and preserve, share the disseminate the resources by the ETDs, electronic thesis and dissertation submitted by the, this is the Shodh Ganga project. Finally, 165,000 plus thesis are available, 3,900 synopses are available, and you know, like universities, 300 universities are contributing, and university with MOU 346, this is the National Digital Library, another initiative is there. See, just you check it out here, search by browse, UGC and guide tutorials, download that we can. Earlier researchers, dissertations and thesis they can access from the Shodh Ganga. Then another but not least one. See, there are some Open educational resources like journals and textbooks websites are there, around plenty of the resources. It may be like 1200 resources journals and 4200 open access books and open access resources. It contain the books and resources and journals are available. It contain videos and audio lectures also is available that we can access freely. There is no restriction, there is no permission to seek the particular institutions. These particular, you know, like now we discussed about the Foreign Open Initiative and Indian Open Initiative, open education resources, how, where it is available, how we can access, what is the path exactly, where that particular institution is providing, how many video lectures, audio lectures are available and how we can access. Now we discussed about this one. Next class we will discuss about the National Digital Library, how, what are the resources are providing and how we can access. And thank you each and everyone.